In this video, we try to answer the question, do artificial sweeteners cause insulin release? Another question I get all the time, especially on forums on intermittent fasting, is, do artificial sweeteners break your fast? Welcome to my channel. I am the lifting dermatologist, a Belgian doctor with 28 years of weightlifting experience. If this is your first time here and you want me to help and motivate you losing fat, building more muscle, and an aesthetic physique, next to tips and tricks on dermatology and skincare, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Artificial sweeteners are used in such small quantities that they don't increase calorie intake. However, they react with receptors on the tongue to give people the sensation of tasting something sweet without the calories associated with natural sweeteners such as table sugar. Artificial sweeteners taste like glucose or fructose, but are chemically totally different. Let's take a look at the possible positive effects. For a lot of people, like me, drinking artificially sweetened soda helps in the weight loss effort by making you snack less in between meals. This is partly due to less cravings and partly to the filling up effect of the volume of the sweet tasting soda. So, what about epidemiological data that has demonstrated an association between artificial sweeteners use and weight gain? In interpreting such studies, it is critical to consider the conditions required to support causality, including the strength of the association, consistency in findings, etc. Based on these criteria, causality is far from established with regard to artificial sweetener use and weight gain. Artificial sweetener intake is likely to be an indicator for other variables. For example, people choosing diet sodas tend to eat unhealthy processed junk foods more than people never drinking diet sodas. Another possibility, the decision to consume artificial sweeteners is often made by individuals who are concerned about their weight in an effort to reduce their caloric intake. So it could be that overweight people drink more diet soda instead of regular soda once they decide they want to lose weight, which is actually a good decision. What are the possible negative effects? Gut flora disturbances, the promotion of psychological dependencies on sweets, unknown long-term safety issues, and of course, the negative effect of the acids in the sodas on the teeth. So, do artificial sweeteners have an insulinogenic effect? Do they cause insulin release? Will they break your fast? Artificial sweeteners is not a monolithic entity. There are multiple types of sweeteners, all of them chemically distinct from each other. A more useful question would be, what effect does one specific artificial sweetener have on insulin? So, let's take a closer look. Does aspartame affect insulin? Research seems to suggest little, if any, effect on insulin secretion as a result of tasting or consuming aspartame. Does saccharin affect insulin? The evidence for saccharin's effect on insulin is mixed, but either way, it doesn't appear to have too big of an impact in real-world terms. Does acesulfam potassium affect insulin? Acesulfam potassium appears to affect insulin levels, although this effect has only been shown in contrived settings, either in the presence of glucose in isolated cells, in vitro, in isolated cells without glucose, in vitro, or by direct transfusions without the presence of glucose in vivo. We haven't seen people orally taking acesulfam potassium in a fasted state and having an insulin response. Yet. Does sucralose affect insulin? There's not much, if any, evidence that sucralose has an independent in vivo effect on insulin. Does stevia affect insulin? Stevia's effect on insulin can only be postulated because available study results are preliminary and need to be validated with larger quality human studies. It may be wise to use stevia sweetener in moderation, just like most zero or low calorie sweeteners. Conclusion. Recently, a review of in vivo studies concluded that low-energy sweeteners do not have any of the effects on insulin, appetite or blood glucose predicted by in vitro, in situ, or knockout studies in animals. According to the literature, there isn't any appreciable insulin effect from most sweeteners. Let's conclude this video by saying that in theory, artificial sweeteners in fairly limited quantities will not cause health issues. However, not all are created equal and they can exert different effects. Is it going to make a huge difference? Probably not. Still, probably best not to make it your primary liquid of choice. As always, the poison is in the dose. And as always, I'd love to hear about your personal experiences with artificial sweeteners, especially regarding their effect on your weight loss efforts, insulin levels, appetite, and dietary success or failures. Let me know in the comment section.